Hi, I'm Ashley, and welcome to Subtracting Unknown Numbers. In this video, we're going to practice finding an unknown number in subtraction problems. You ready? Let's go. Like with adding unknown numbers, we can use fact families to help us find the missing number in a subtraction problem as well. So look at this example fact family here on the left. I have 3 plus 2 equals 5, 2 plus 3 equals 5. Then the sum becomes the first problem of the last two subtraction problems, or the first number, sorry. 5 minus 3 equals 2, and 5 minus 2 equals 3. Notice that in these two problems, the numbers just switch places. This is what will help us. Let me show you what I mean. So if I had a different problem, let's say 6 minus an unknown is equal to 4. Just like over here, 5 minus 3 equals 2, the 2 switched places, 5 minus 2 equals 3. So then the 3 came over here. So I can do the same thing. I'll do another subtraction problem. 6 minus, let me bring my 4 down, 6 minus 4 is equal to what? This is the answer. 6 minus 4 equals 2. So that means 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. Let's try this with some of our problems from the game. See here, I have 5 minus a number equals 3. So if I just move that 3 over, then I will get the other problem in our fact family, and this will help us find the unknown number. Let's say I have 5 and I take away 3, what do I get? 5 minus 3 equals 2. And there is our answer. Let's try another one a little bit more challenging. Okay, my next one here is 46 minus a number equals 9. Let's just move the 9 over and take it away from 46 and see what we get. 46 minus 9 equals, notice I'm subtracting vertically so I can keep my numbers or my place values lined up because I will need to borrow, and this is very helpful. So I cannot take 9 away from 6 because 9 is bigger, so I will have to borrow from the tens place. Take one 10 away, that means I have 3 10s. Add that 10 to the 6 makes 16. So 16 minus 9 is 7. Now 3 minus nothing is 3. Look over here. Here's our answer, 37. Now if we wanted, we could go back and check our work by plugging in this 37 into the problem. So let's try that. So plugging it in, I have 46, and I'm going to subtract 37 and see if we get 9. Okay, we cannot take 7 from 6, so we have to borrow. The 4 becomes a 3, 6 becomes 16. 16 minus 7 equals 9. And 3 minus 3 is 0, so our final answer, 9. So that means 46 minus 37 equals 9. And we confirmed that by checking our work. All right, so with this next one, we have 103 minus an unknown equals 67. Let's flip that problem around. So we have 103, and let's subtract 67. 7 from 3, We'll need to borrow, which we cannot because there are no tens to borrow from. So we'll need to borrow from the hundreds. We now have 0 hundreds, which makes 10 tens. Now we can borrow from the tens place. So we have 9 tens. That makes this 3 a 13. So 13 minus 7 is 6. 9 minus 6 is 3. 0 minus 0 is nothing. So we have nothing in the hundreds place. Our answer is 36. 103 minus 36 equals 67. I'm going to work through one last problem here. This comes from our subtracting unknown numbers 2 game, and it is a bit more advanced. It does include negative numbers. So if you have not learned those yet, don't worry about it. Don't go to that game yet. Just stick with unknown numbers 1. And when you're ready and you have learned negatives, then you are ready to start subtracting unknown numbers 2. All right, so let's look at this. Now, I'm going to do this the same way. I will take my difference here, move it over, so that I'm going to now have 28 minus a negative 90 equals what? Well, if you remember, when you subtract a negative, the subtraction and negative sign go together to make a positive or a plus. So now I have 28 plus 90. Let me rewrite this vertically. 28 plus 90 is equal to what? Well, 8 plus 0 is 8. 9 and 2 is 11. So my final answer is 118. And that's it. Be sure you go practice what you've learned with our online games and quizzes, and remember to always be clever.